Hello and welcome to another episode of me painting again. Oh yeah, we're painting again. Put my old painter's shirt on. I've got my piece of chalk. Bing! I've got my canvas ready and I'm ready to paint. Ready to have a go at this one. This is a photo that I took and I just like the lighting of it actually. I like the way the light was over here, sort of casting this sort of almost a purple, a bluey purple shadow, which I really liked. And I thought, that would make an interesting subject to paint, so we'll have a go. We could make the sky a bit bigger, or make this higher, be up here. Then we can have more beach. We'll have a look. We'll just mess around. Got this grassy sort of shape in with a stick of chalk. Got sort of this sort of shape. We can change it as well. That sort of shape, and then a lump. That's further down. It's further down. That one. Good thing about chalk is you can wipe it away if you don't like what you've done. Anyway, something like that, and that sort of goes down. Shapes like that. Maybe more like that. And we've got the shadow, light. Yeah, that gives us the base anyway, gives us the basic idea. So we've got our light going ching 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 ching. Our grass sort of mound there and there. Sort of mound. Or dunes or whatever you would call this. Those are like dunes, aren't they? Yeah. Angry face. So we'll put in the sky first. Got a minimalistic palette again. The alizarin crimson, ultramarine blue, cadmium yellow, burnt umber, and titanium white. And what we want is a nice sky. Blue and white, let's see if that's about right. Yep, I just quickly checked that and it's perfect. So I'll put that in. And all the paints I'm using at the moment are artist quality paints. Well, some of them I've made them, and I've only used linseed oil and pigment, so there's no fillers in them. And you'll notice that when you put paint on like this, it just covers so well. And if you're wondering the difference between student quality and artist quality, it's the amount of pigment and what pigments they use as well, because some pigments are a lot more expensive than others. So you're like expensive ones. This is the high like season series 4 or something paints. They're really expensive. They're usually because of the pigment they're using. It's costly, but it just covers better anyway. The when you have artist paints, it covers better. Student paints a lot of them have fillers in, and that makes them cover a little less as good. So I'll put a bit more white in, because towards the horizon it's a bit lighter. Lighter blue. I'm not putting tons of paint on though, I have to say. It's quite thin. And I don't want to put tons on, because then my next layer will be harder to go on. Just enough to cover. Just enough to cover the we've got here. Yeah, so I thought I'd try painting this, because I've never painted something like this before. That tends to be my reasoning to paint stuff a lot of the time, because I've not done it before. I'm inspired by something. So I see something and it inspires me, then I'll paint that. I'll keep some sky colour just in case. Well, there we go, it's nice and smooth anyway. Pretty good, pretty happy with that. Yep, we'll leave it at that, and then we'll start looking at the grass. My brush to one side. Use this brush. I'm using all like Bob Ross filbert brushes at the moment. They seem to work quite well for me. Quite good brushes, actually. Good size. So we want sort of a greeny. I'm going to put my dark in first, and it's quite a greeny brownie. So some blue, some yellow, some crimson. So we've got crimson in there. So we've got our green. Yellow and blue, of course, that makes our green. The crimson will dull the green. Let's see what that looks like. Needs to be a lot more. Just put some brown in it. Not that there's much white in this paint. Okay. Hmm. It wants to be a bit warmer. I think I'll go with that. It's sort of a brownie colour. It's not far off anyway. So I'm going with this area. Scrub this in. Goes a lot lighter here. Well, a bit anyway. Maybe that like that. Yeah, Whoops, I've taken away some of my light there. I'll be able to put some back on it, don't matter though. It's quite dark here. Remind myself, say to myself, well, I can always put paint on top to make it lighter or darker, as long as I put the paint on first that is thin, like scrubbed on, so it's not a really thick application of paint. Because a really thick application of paint is really difficult to paint on top of. So I don't want to do that. So what I want to do next is my shadow colour. I think it's a bit of ultramarine blue and crimson and white. More blue. So I'm testing. We are close. We are very, very close. A bit more white in it. It's amazing actually when you check colours, because I thought that was too purpley colour, but when you put it next to it, look, it's perfect over here. Maybe it's a bit too bright over there. Amazing though, isn't it? Alright, so we've got this shape. See, my brain is still trying to fight this colour. It's still saying in my head, that's too purpley. It's too purpley. Rubbing that in. Okay, there we go. We need our sand in, really, don't we? Something like that. Now, I want a little bit of light on the dunes. So, get some of this yellow, crimson, brown. Bit of the blue. It's not bad. Put some of that there. Just looking at that, looking for spots where I can add a bit of something. I want a bit more of a greeny colour as well. Cadmium yellow. Put the bit of dirt in it, dirty colour. Something like that. Vanishes a little bit, but trying to get the effect. So I'm not going to paint every blade of grass or anything. Trying to get that movement in place. Needs neutralizing a little bit. Dulling a little bit. There's some sort of a colour in this. That one. I might add colour in there that's not there. Why not? You know, it's your painting, isn't it? Sometimes you need to jazz it up a little bit. Warm things up like there. Always having a quick sit back, having a look. Switch in between colour. Some of those bits in there as well. Get this kind of really dull yellow. It's not quite it, but when I get a bit of white in it, it'll be closer. I do quite like it though. I can go on some of these bits here. Just sit back. Look at that. A bit more white in this. Using them, them all famous brush strokes. Not light in this bit there. A bit of a twinkle on that bit. And now, before I carry on, I think I'm going to do a bit of light on that bit there as well. I'm actually quite enjoying this. Enjoy painting it. It's fun trying to get something that has the same essence. Yeah, so we try and put some sand in there and then put a bit of light there as well. Okay. Right, we want some of the sand. So it's gonna be white for sure. It's yellow. Pinkish. Some red in it. It's more of a white, a warm yellow ochre. Actually, warmer. Put some brown in it. Some burnt umber. It's not quite warm enough. A bit more of the crimson. Show you what I'm trying to get, colour like this. Very close now. Oh, wait, I am probably a little bit too needs a bit more crimson. Ooh. That's quite close. We've got like a crimson and yellow and brown and white. We've got really close there. So we'll go with it. It's almost a flesh colour. When you buy a tube of paint and you get flesh tone, it reminds me of that. Right, let's see if we can get some of this light in there then. Cover it there. Better not put too much paint on. Sort of flick it into this. I flick up, it's going to work better. Then I've got to remember to get rid of some of that colour. Look into this as well, break that up. Actually, if I scrub it on, it will be a tiny bit transparent, and that will be my dark. Some of, well, maybe my mid-tone. Can you just sort of sit back, have a look at that? That's not bad, actually. Yeah, I didn't mind that. What I might do... do a little bit of yellow. Just pull some areas out a little bit. Just to make some little bright spots. It shows that light coming down. I'm not going to go as bright there, because I think I'll keep it in this area. I want to get rid of the old blue and white. Blue and white. We're trying to make a blue very similar in tone to this. It's slightly lighter, but it's alright. I'm going to start making shapes in it. Otherwise, it's just going to be a block of this colour. I want it to break up a little bit of other colours. sort of a brownish colour in it as well. Changes it a little bit. Break up that. Yeah, quite like that. So we'll sit back, have a look at that. I want this this bit there. A bit of green. It's quite a nice green actually. I might put that in somewhere. Here and there. See how you kind of can build stuff up a little bit as you go. Yeah, quite like that. It's got like an impressionistic look to it. There's all kinds of colours going on now. Kind of like the idea of a door. Something like a dull red. Dull reddy yellowy colour. Sort of a brown. Like a warm browny colour. Let's see what this looks like. Strokes in there. Oh, that's broken that up a bit better. Need a little bit more on that. Oops. Want a little bit more on this. That's better, I prefer that. I want a bit more variety in here. Yeah, throw in a few, lots of bits on the floor. Okay, maybe some down here as well as some bits. Yeah, and I might put what I'm thinking. Say, I don't remember seeing any birds there. But I'm still thinking about putting one in. If I found a brush for fine enough, I think all my brushes are too big. Just a few there. That'll do. So thanks very much for watching this episode. Hope you enjoyed it. Hope it gave you an idea of what you could do with a few colours and a desire and a canvas and some paints. Wait, I said a few colours already, didn't I? So yeah, thanks very much for watching this episode, and I'll see you in another one. Cheers, bye.